Hey, Sashan, what is going on? Everyone knows that GURPS, the generally useless role-playing system, does not allow for role-play. It's mostly a video game that you play by hand using paper and pencil, some dice. GURPS is a great system. But it belongs in a video game. But there are those that insist on playing it manually, without batteries, and they will tell you in a heartbeat that they're role players. And that's a huge lie. There are no GURPS role players. There's no such thing as a GURPS role player. It's just too much. The game says, hey, you can be any character you want to be. Yeah, that's true. But can you role play any character you want to be? No. You're basically an avatar in GURPS, and you have all the GURPS settings for your character. All the advantages, the disadvantages. It's a point buy thing. So already you're at a disadvantage if you're trying to role play your character, because now you have to keep track of all the points that you've accrued, spent, making your character, optimizing your min-maxed character so you can win the game. GURPS is all about winning the game. So let's just, hypothetically, we'll say that so and so who plays GURPS. I used to play GURPS, by the way. I played it for like 10 years. I thought this game has it's I'll do another video on GURPS, but anyway. Let's pretend that there's someone out there who's actually, who says, I'm a GURPS role player. What about me? Well, chances are they fly like a moth towards this thing, the GURPS game aid. Think of Fantasy Grounds, but times a thousand. What little role play you actually do? Think you have in a GURPS game session? It's been thoroughly removed. Art, this is RPR at its best. Role play removed. The GURPS game aid leaves no room for role play whatsoever at the table or the virtual table or at the anywhere. You'll see. This is a huge. This game aid is a huge undertaking. It's an amazing thing if you look at it from one angle, but if you look at it from another angle like I do, I'm against it. Because this disallows role play. It's all about the metagame.
This is the feature video for the 0.13.5 release. And the very first feature I want to show you is one that people have been asking for a while. If you look down here in the modifier bucket, there is now a magnet. If you turn the magnet on, any modifiers that you add will stay there after the roll. That's it. You can just keep on rolling the same stuff if you want, and the modifiers will stay there. You turn the magnet off, and the modifier bucket empties like normal.
Just the idea of needing a DM to to be there and not go away after each roll is it tells you a great deal about the game system you're in. Personally, I would not have used a magnet. I would have used a sticky note for that. Anyway.
The best icon I could find was a magnet, meaning, the stuff sticks there. But trust me, with only that little bit of space, it's difficult to find a really good icon. So I picked the magnet. The next feature is for GMs. A lot of GMs have asked for this. If you want to make a blind.
Or a pin. You could just use a pin, Windows uses pins all the time.
Perception rolls for all of your player characters. You can do that with a chat command now. The everyone command, if you make it private by putting a bang in front of it, It will execute this locally for the GM, and the GM will see the results, but the player characters will just see the blind roll. So here I'll do quietly everyone perception roll.
That's what do they call that? That's readable. When I look at that, I know instantly what that means. Quiet everyone perception. I don't know. What has GURPS become in the last 20 years?
So you see the perception rolls. Then I'll quickly bring over the client and you'll see it what it looks like for them. They just see the question mark dice and that the GM has rolled two dice rolls. Don't know why.
I don't use perception rolls, so that feature is useless to me.
The next feature is we've added an optional target to the slash HP or slash FP commands so that player characters can heal other player characters. So here, Bernice is going to try to heal Bog, and this is it, slash HP plus one at target. Now, if she hasn't selected a target, you get this error message. But if a target is selected, then we'll look at the client for the Bog owner, and this dialogue appears. It says, Bernice wants to execute HP plus one on Bog. Is that okay? So you can't just suck everybody's health or fatigue away, and you get to decide whether it's beneficial and you can accept it. So I can say yes, and then health gets, then Bog.
That's like a private chat almost. But instead of sending a private chat to another player, can I heal you? Can you heal me real quick? You know, that kind of thing. Without the DM even knowing this is going on, you know. Are they still playing GURPS when the players are doing this kind of stuff? Shouldn't there be like a narration of some sort, like, I noticed that Bog's injured or something. I'm going to go heal him. Or her. I don't know who Bog is. So the other players know what's wrong, you know. What about Bog? And then they also know about the other player who's going to go heal him. Or try to heal him. Could be an automatic easy thing, you know. It's just you don't have to roll for it to see if the healing is successful or not. But when it's done in the private chat section of the interface, then it's like, what are the players doing? Anyway, what else this thing can do?
Bog gets his plus one health. Some more features we've added. We've updated the GCA 5 exporter. It works better now with inventory. We've combined the NPC mini and NPC mini conditional injury character sheets into one. It now all works as one. And for our range calculations, we now support the by the book range on the standard speed, size, and range table. So if you are doing ranges in 11,000 hexes, we now correctly calculate the modifier for that. And another feature we've added is move type. Here you can see Bog has the move type of ground. That's the default move type. But you can add other move types. Let's say Bog can fly. To do so, you have to open up the editor, and down by the move type is this pencil symbol. If you click on that, you can edit the various move types. We also support enhanced move. So if Bog had an enhanced move, then you would enter in the value of what that enhanced move would be here in the enhanced column. But I'm going to add a new move type, and we have...
Add a new move type? Instead of change the move type, you're going to add a move type? Ay, ay, ay. Remember when XL... was the bee's knees? I guess now it's this.
Air, water, space, ground, and of course, other. So I'll say he has air at a 7, but it has an enhanced move of 15. Now I have to tab out so it remembers that. And then I'll go back to the full view, and you can see here in the ground view, he just has a regular move. But if I switch to air now, it shows the regular move and the enhanced move. And of course, we use the encumbrance calculation to determine what the move values are at each level of encumbrance. And this has been integrated into drag ruler. So Bog in air.
Can you imagine if Fallout used the GURPS system? Can you imagine? Everyone would be playing Fallout instead of trying to do it this way. I have GURPS. It's in my Fallout game. Why would I want to do it like this? I already have a game that uses GURPS. It's called Fallout. Wouldn't that be something?
Air move can move 7 with an enhanced move of 15. So if I try to move Bog, you could see there's 7. Actually, let me zoom out to get a little more space here. There you go. You can see we've taken over the sprint location to show you the enhanced move. So yellow is either sprinting if you don't have an enhanced move, or the enhanced move distance. So
it's been a while since I played GURPS. I don't remember enhanced move. I don't know if I ever used that or not. It basically, you just moved, right? I'm an enhanced move. Okay.
You know what that is. Nick did some really good work with this. So for those of you that have different move types, you can now model them in Foundry. And this next feature, I honestly don't know all the ramifications.
Oh, this is Foundry? Foundry Virtual Table? Oh, man. Sounds horrible.
Applications for this, I expect our user community is going to figure out some really cool things, but you can now use the margin of success or failure in dice rolls and on-the-fly formulas. So let me do a skill here. So Bernice will do acrobatics, and there you go. Margin of failure is now -3. So I can do things like this, create a modifier. If I click on this, it will take the last margin of failure that I had rolled, and it's just for my client, and add that into the modifier bucket. So
notice how he says client? It's weird. It's like he's role-playing a game server, and he has clients logged in.
It's adding a -3. So if I click this, I should get a -3 in the modifier bucket, and I do. And in the modifier bucket, you can see that it's because of the margin of failure thing. Now, if we do something different, let's see, I'll try a broadsword. And now we have a margin of failure of +1. If I click on this add margin of failure button to the modifier bucket, it's now +1. And you can use it in damage formulas. Here's a damage formula to create 2D plus whatever the margin of failure is.
Oh yeah, I would have done it so that instead of clicking on whatever this thing is, I would fix it so you clicked on the actual missed it by 3, made it by 1. You click on those instead of this other thing you're clicking on. Margin cut, whatever it's called.
Cutting damage. So right now the margin of failure is 1. Margin of success is 1. So we'll click that and I should get 2d plus 1. And if we look at the dice, you can see I rolled a 4 and a 1, and there's the +1 because of the margin of success. You can, of course, subtract the margin of success or failure. So here I'm creating a button that will roll versus bog strength, subtracting any margin of success I may have had, which means if you had a margin of failure, a negative number, you're doing a negative of negative number, it'd be a positive number. So I'll leave the math to you, but this will roll strength -1. And of course, you can apply it to...
By the way, if you do watch GURPS game sessions on YouTube using this software, I suggest rolling for sanity.
Skill rolls or melee and attack rolls. So here we're going to take the, we're going to roll the acrobatic skill and we're going to subtract whatever we have as the margin of failure. Well, the last margin of failure we had is a -2. So if we're subtracting the -2, then that should give us a +2. So this will be acrobatics at a +2. So my general recommendation is you just roll plus, but you know, you can figure out the math. And this also works in standard roles, just any place where you can use the at gmod or at gmodc. You can also use at margin. So any standard Foundry role syntax, you can use it, which includes role tables. So here, this table, the role.
Oh, I see. So this is built, this GURPS game aid is built on the Foundry system. So you have to go by the Foundry rules, which is another layer of cluster fuck, if you ask me. GURPS has a huge-ass learning curve to begin with, and now you're adding more complication with this game aid, because now the players have to learn how to use this app. Chances are they've never heard of Foundry, so they have to learn Foundry first. I'm guessing there's a client version of Foundry that's free, so they have to get their experience in with that before they can then install the game aid on it, before they can be in a GURPS game. And I don't know if you can practice using it until you're actually in a game, so technically you can't learn how to use the game aid for GURPS until you're in a game session using the game aid for GURPS. And then the entire GURPS game session on YouTube ends up being a let's learn how to use the GURPS game aid for the next 4 hours. And no wonder the episode 2 or the episode 3 in the video, in the playlist of that channel's videos for GURPS, no wonder there's like the revolving door of players, is someone just gives up. It's like, you know what? It was fun that one time, but no, I'm not coming back again. Thank you, but no thank you. And then they have to find another player to show up for the next game session. And it's just a revolving door of players. It's sad. It's just an upward battle constantly. It's hard enough to find... Well, I'll take this back. It's not hard at all to find people off the street that are gullible, that you can sucker into your game session and trick them into doing it this way. They're thinking D&D, because you told them, we're going to play GURPS. What's GURPS? Well, GURPS is like D&D. Oh, D&D, I've heard of D&D. I'll show up. Man on the street, I'll show up. And then they find out they got to go through all this nonsense, and it's like, where's the D&D I was told about? And it's sad. It's sad how far the hobby has fallen in the last 20, 30 years. Everyone, it's like people settle for this because to them it's the only way they can get players to join their game. We'll make GURPS easier for you. We have a game aid for GURPS. It'll make playing GURPS so much simpler. Trust me. Isn't GURPS that 3d6 roll under mechanic? Oh, yeah, but pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. You'll like it. We have game aid for Foundry. You can download. We're going to have a great roleplay session. Oh. Yay. But it's really hard to find role players. It's really easy to find new players and teach them to role play. That's what I do. I find new players fresh off the boat and teach them how to role play in about 40 minutes. These guys, they're just looking for
I'm a 30-year role-play veteran of the hobby. I've been DMing games for 40 years, you know.
So it sounds like they know what they're doing, right? Even though they've been doing it wrong for 40 years, it still sounds like, hey, this guy knows something. He has experience. He's a veteran. I'll join his game. It'll be fun. He's been doing this for 40 years. It must be fun 40 years for him. Anyway. What are they doing now?
Roll formula is just 1 plus whatever the margin of success was. And the last margin of success we had was a 1. So when I roll this, and I'm using air quotes, of course, it should actually just roll a 2. And there it is. It's 1 plus 1. So I leave it up to you, my faithful users. Can you use that feature? I hope so, because it's there now. All right, the next feature is an enhancement to the if chat command. Using the advanced format with the curly braces, You can now identify if something, what to do when something is a critical success, a failure, or a critical failure. And these two formats are the same because by default, the first unlabeled curly brace is what you do with a success. And the second unlabeled curly brace is what you do with a fail. But now you can do stuff based on critical success and critical failure results. And of course, we fixed a few.
Okay, that should have been put in there in version 0.0.1. Why is it waiting until version 13.5 to get that?
Few bugs here and there. And one thing I wanted to add, if you did not have any resource trackers, you can go into the editor and here under resource tracker, you can say add a resource tracker. Okay. So not everybody knew that. And as such, we'd get a lot of questions. How do I add resource trackers? So I decided I wanted to add in a quick little thing. So here in the Melee bar, there's a smaller little button that says add resource tracker. And if you click that button, then a resource tracker will be added. And of course, then it disappears from the Melee bar. It's not the prettiest at the moment, but it gets the job done so people don't get lost. So now the resource tracker stuff works. You can edit and add in thresholds and you know, build your whole resource tracker. There is a whole section on the user's guide for how to do this. Please look that up. All in all, I'm actually really excited by this release. The magnet on the modifier bucket has been something that a lot of people have asked for a really long time, and I never could figure out a good user interface way that I wanted to make it happen. And the magnet seems to work. And the ability for the GM to type in one command, which of course then they can drag into a macro bar, the /EV perception roll, which allows...
Okay, well, enough of this. After watching this, I am so gung-ho about trying out this game aid. I can't wait to join a game, a group of GURPS players who use this Foundry game aid thing. Oh, man. I can see the role play experience unfolding. Those of you at home who watch my videos, you already know that this is just a huge scam. It's a distraction. It's a come this way. We have something different than what you're used to. Come this way. Come join our group. Come join our Discord. I don't use Discord, so I don't get lured into those traps of these Discord servers where you're told the things you will see, the places you will go, and then you go to this Discord server and it's just a bunch of losers with pronouns that you don't want to use, and none of them are role players, and they're all, I don't want to say it, so I won't say it. Anyway, talk to you later.